we need a real system transformation, which means our system has to fundamentally change, including all aspects, infrastructure, behavior, supply, technologies, demand.
I don't think that we are heading for dramatic change within the transport system, but we are heading for an evolutionary kind of change.
In a digital environment that we all live in now, it's very important for not just passengers, but also organizations, companies, such as logistics companies, to be aware of information related to data, travel and connectivity, not just within their immediate environment, but also around neighboring environments, including other countries as well.
To improve sustainable mobility, we need to put in practice all the solutions we have. This forum has solutions, but the politics must put them in practice. And also, we must immediately start a new education on children. It's a generation problem.
What I would request is real innovation in changing everything and supporting people in changing behavior. Building new technologies, innovating new technologies, not only improving the given ones, making them more efficient or so, this won't help.
I think that the technologies that will be most influential will be those technologies that support nudging and incentivizing individuals to make changes within their travel behavior. And that process of nudging and incentivizing will arise from people having access to technologies that inform them about the value proposition for them in terms of making more sustainable transport choices.
I think that the best policy measures for urban mobility is a combination of measures or policy. But I mean, you have to look what is the demand in a city. And you see in lots of cities in Europe, you have a lot of traffic jams. So you need a fast and a quick mobility. And bicycle, for example, is really good. So you have to create ICT solutions who support the demand.
You have to change the idea of owning a car with the idea of using a car. We have to give travelers a real efficient alternative to cars.
We need to encourage people, and there I see the role of policy and planning, as the free will of industry won't be enough. So I think policy has a responsibility here to further increase support and also put pressure to come to this development.
Whilst it's very positive and good to have the different mechanisms, different technologies, different policies, it needs to be integrated and it needs to be a cohesive approach. So any infrastructure investment that is undertaken needs to take into account not only the users but also the reasons behind the investment of that infrastructure.
If 85% of us are going to be living in cities, if the vast majority of car journeys are going to begin and in cities, then the unit over which you have to plan transport and plan transport change and plan smart mobility is the city. It's about transport for London, it's about Zurich, it's about the things we've heard that people are doing in Berlin and elsewhere. That presents the EU with an enormous problem because the EU deals with countries.